Hi folks, welcome to another episode of the Critter Cam. My name is Ryan Panacey and I'm a photographer living on the North Shore. I focus on wildlife and one of the tools I use is a trail camera. I set one a couple weeks ago, let's go check it. We're here at the trail camera, let's see what kind of wild animals we caught on film here. Had this out a couple weeks. Huh, that's weird. Is that a Bigfoot? Oh, that's Carol. That's Robbie. And this was just a couple minutes ago. I wonder if we can catch up with them. Let's go.
Ma, 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 ma.
Red leather, yellow leather, la, red la, leather, la, yellow la, leather. Oh, today's gonna be so fun.
Oh my gosh, I know, right? And what are we doing? Wait, and also, why do you have a blanket?
It's animal science today, but mystery style, and this is my lucky filming blanket, which my agent gets for me before I film.
Oh, really? Well, my agent normally gets me a counted bag of green M&Ms, but today they just gave me a bag of Skittles.
Who's your agent?
I don't have one.
Mm. Hey, Carol.
Hey.
Hey, Robbie.
Hey, Ryan.
What's going on?
We were just about to film Adventures in Learning for this week. What are you doing here?
Well, the weirdest thing, I was just checking a trail camera and I got photos of you too.
Oh, no way. Weird. Yeah, we're just setting up for the lesson here. Well, since you're here, do you want to see some really cool animal signs that Carol and I found?
Yeah, I would love to. That sounds like a lot of fun.
Awesome. Let's do it.
We were getting ready to film today and saw these wood chips on the ground sprinkled about. And then we got closer to this tree and noticed that there's a bunch of them right here.
And we're gonna take a closer look at those wood chips and use some tools to see what else we can learn about them.
Hey, I have a rubber chicken to use.
And I've got a ruler. And this wood chip looks like it's about an inch long.
I think you mean a seventh of this chicken.
Mm. So we've measured the wood chips, but now I wanna find out what tree they're from. I'm gonna taste it.
I also have a tree identification guide we can use. Oh my gosh, and a leaf. Oh, it looks like a maple leaf.
Tastes like a maple too.
Robbie, I'm looking in this hole here and I'm seeing some grooves probably made by whatever or whoever made this hole. And also way in there, I see other tiny, tiny little holes in there.
And if we look up the tree as well, there's actually another hole that's almost as big as this one. And there's three or four right here.
Wow, I think it maybe be a good idea for us to take some of these wood chips with us as we're exploring so that we can use them as evidence.
We've got an animal sign here, a hole in the tree. Do either of you have a guess as to what might have done this?
Well, we have some guesses, but not a whole lot of evidence to support any of them. I was kind of thinking bears because we've been seeing bears around this area lately, and maybe it was scratching at the tree kind of like a cat scratches at a scratching post.
And I think it's beavers because I know they love to chew up trees and maybe they created all those wood chips there on the ground.
Oh, wait a second, wait. Actually, I'm changing my answer. I think it's a bird. I don't know.
Well, that's okay. I know spots on campus where we can check out all three of those animals. There's beaver activity down by Sawmill Creek. There are bear scratches up by the bird feeders, by the birch trees. And there's also a pileated woodpecker nest down by the gravel pit. Let's go check it out. So here's an area where beavers have been working. They've really changed this landscape. There's a dam over there, and there's also a lodge upstream. Let's see what other beaver signs we can find.
Whoa, check this out. It looks like there's this huge path here. I wonder, is that from the beavers?
Yeah, Robbie, that's called a drag.
Nice.
And so the beavers are coming out of the water, they're packing down this trail, and it leads back to an area where they're cutting down trees and they're dragging big branches down to build with.
No way. Okay, let's go follow it. This is massive. So the beavers chewed down this whole tree?
Yeah, Robbie, this is an old beaver chew. They're interested in the branches, the fresh growth at the top of the tree, to get that cambium layer, that inner stuff is really nutritious.
Wow. And I'm seeing a bunch of wood chips on the ground here as well, like there were wood chips at our first tree. But these look a little bit different than the ones we're seeing up top. The ones here from this beaver have got the beaver teeth marks in it versus the ones from our tree earlier don't quite look like that.
Interesting comparison. I'd agree with that, Robbie. Yeah,
so I don't think that first tree, I don't think that was beavers like I originally thought.
So, Robbie, we don't think that it's the beaver because the chips were different. So should we go check out our next guest, which is the bear?
Let's do it.
I was walking by this tree and I noticed something left behind on the trunk. What do you think this is?
Oh, wow. There's a bunch of scratch marks on this tree.
Yeah, you know, bears, they will scratch when they're climbing the tree. Sometimes the bears might climb a tree to escape from potential predators, and the adult bears might scratch as territory markings, or they might even rub their bodies or backs on a tree to leave their scent.
Wow, that's pretty cool. And I'm also noticing that these scratch marks, they go really high up on the tree, some of them. Here, let's measure. 1, 2, 3. These scratch marks are 3.5 chickens up the tree. Wow. But I'm also not noticing that there's any wood chips left behind. Let's go back to our other tree and check it out. I came back to our mystery tree to look for any bear claw marks, and I'm not seeing any like the ones that we saw over there with Ryan. Also, we have wood chips here by our tree, and we didn't see any by the other bear scratch marks, so I don't think a bear did the sign here.
So far, I've been recording all the observations I've been making as we're investigating our animal sign in my nature journal. You can do the same thing too and take notes on what you're seeing outside. You could also write a story in your nature journal. It's kind of fun to write it from the animal's perspective. What was it doing? Why was it doing it? And kind of craft this cool little story in your journal.
So we were walking down the trail and spotted these holes on the tree here. You can see that they're all in a line. And last year, I remember watching a sapsucker make these exact holes in this same tree. So now we know that woodpeckers will be making holes similar to this. Down at the base of the tree, I poked around and found some super tiny wood chips that came out of these holes, much smaller than the wood chips from the spot where we were originally looking. So this couldn't have been the same animal. The sapsucker that made these holes is only about this big, and the wood chips that we found at the first tree are massive. That must mean that the woodpecker we're looking for is huge.
So the last thing that we have to look at is a pileated woodpecker nest. It's in this large, mature, quaking aspen tree about 50 feet off the ground. The parents excavated the hole and they're incubating their eggs in there to keep them safe from predators. So now we're going to quietly observe the nest and see what kind of pileated woodpecker behaviors we can see. When we're observing wildlife, it's important that we show the animals respect, especially in this kind of situation where it's a nest. It's a sensitive time of year for these birds in the breeding season, and so we want to be mindful of that, and we want to watch for behaviors that might show that they're agitated and leave if we have to. So I'm looking at the cavity and I see the male poking out of the hole, and they're calling to each other, the male and the female. The male leaves the cavity and the female arrives to take his place. They share the incubation responsibility.
So we came to the base of the pileated tree where we saw the nest higher up, and oh hey look, there's something on the ground.
These chips look exactly like the ones we saw at our original mystery tree, which means that that must have been a pileated woodpecker.
In the maple tree.
With its beak. Wow, what a wild adventure, all before we even got the desk set up.
Truly, and unfortunately, this will be the last video for Carol and I in the online series, but Wolf Ridge will have more online lessons coming out throughout the summer, so make sure you check back in.
You know, we haven't even sat down at the desk yet today, Robbie, but I don't really want to. It's so nice. Let's go look outside.
And you should too. Take a walk around your yard or your neighborhood. find some animal signs and uncover the mystery.
Cool. So, we're looking at Woodpecker. What if in the next scene we have Carol get really hyped about the bird and pull out the binos? What do you both think?
That'll just be the next scene we have coming up.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
That sounds great. Yeah,
3, 2, 1.
Katie, what'd you think of those clips?
Love it. I love the frog close-up.
Done!
Packaging time!
I got the stuff! I got the stuff! Journal. All right, Christopher.
Right, a box of animal signs.
So, Carol, I hear Adventures in Learning is done and you need a talent agent for your next project.
Oh my gosh, I don't actually have an agent. Would you be my agent?
Oh, totally sign me up. I can tell you're gonna be a star, so. Who do you want to work with? You want a J.J. Abrams, a Michael Bay picture?
Wes Anderson.
Oh, Wes Anderson. Oh, he's got golden stuff. That's great. You'll be eating green candies the rest of your life. Tell you what, let me get him on the phone.
Let me help you.
I don't have fingers, darling. Yes, hello, Wes. Yes, I have the perfect star for your next picture. Yeah, she does nature stuff.
Where's my ruler? Right in the ground in front of me. Like sticking out of the ground. like a tree. Ah. Oh, I hope that makes the fire.
Why is it?
Oh no!
Like I said, it's